Sorry, we were momentarily disconnected. Don't know what caused that. We got disconnected 3-4 times. It's on Twitch's side, it definitely isn't on my side. I'm staying perfectly 1 gig yellow on this side. So it doesn't make sense why I'm being disconnected.
Energy low.
Well, that shouldn't have happened. But it did. Oh my. I better get back to my space station. I'm sorry, Mr. Books. I mined out the backside. I dug a big hole for it to sit in. And it did the exact opposite that it was supposed to. Look at all that stuff I dug out. I dug out all that material, and it just, as a result of it being dug out, it's like it's being repelled. I have built some stanchions to keep it from crushing your stuff. I would think at this point we need to figure out some way to start building out this way, like this, okay? And then we put the stuff on this side. Yeah, I don't think we want it to roll any further. It's doing the exact opposite. Maybe the game physics are off. I don't know. I just, I can tell you that your refineries are working at top, at top speed.
I think your cargo is what's rolling you over. If it's allowed to continue, it will roll you completely over. Like tumbling weed. Yep, definitely. Oh. Nothing I can do for you other than just go back up to my space station at this point. I tried to dig you out, tried to roll you over. Unfortunately, you're rolling the wrong way. Because you're getting heavier and heavier, and you know, it's your program. It's doing it, it's your mod. You're producing more than you actually ever had. But at any rate, no matter what I did to write you, this bottom half underneath here is killing you. Or you have a gravity generator on here that's pushing you over. Somewhere that you forgot about. Because there's just no way on earth that you could weigh so much. Those cargo containers could weigh that much to roll you over. They are literally, these three items are literally pulling all that steel and all that equipment and machinery completely over. And it's not possible. At any rate, I would leave the little red legs on. The mods are still running, so... glad that's not my ship down there. That's all I have to say. I would have taken a lighter ship. But you know, I mean, what can I say, you know? Could happen to anybody, could happen to me. Anybody can make that mistake. But I'm just glad it didn't happen to me. Anyway, I took down the thing at the people's request. There were a couple of people who said I should pay for my own games. And they were very blunt about it, so... I will figure out a way to pay for my own equipment and pay for everything. They didn't say it over the channel either, so... Some things happened to the O2 in the in-home. It was working fine before. It must just be out of ice. It's blue. time we'll resolve the issue. Okay, so we have air restored to the space station, and we can take our hat off. Not dying now. And I hope to do. The gravel still in the room we're using. info was pulled out. Okay, we got a message of some sort. What did it say? Sorry, I have a problem reloading base engineers real quick. Just give me a minute. Okay, we're back up. Sorry about that. Okay. I'm trying to get rid of two mods that were slowing down my game, and I was getting a report from the game that the mods were still in there. So I was checking to see if the mods were still in there, and I was also checking to see if the other two mods that the game said it was reporting were still in there, and they're not. Hopefully it's going to clear them out. I'm in the middle of building an arc generator. As you guys saw earlier in the broadcast, Mr. Pooks took his big ship, his big Cadillac, down to the surface, and it is resting in pieces. We have disassembled most of it and recovered most of it, but it's wanting to roll over for some reason, which is physically not possible. I don't know why it's wanting to roll over, other than the supernatural cargo he's carrying, and the way it's not distributed evenly. His center of gravity is those two cargo containers, and they're way off to the right. He didn't place anything in the middle, because he likes wide open areas, so he places everything around the outside of the vessel. Fortunately, that is not a good way to go. I'm not downing him or anything else for him, as he sees it cost him dearly. Lost most of his cargo. He's building cargo containers. He's taking the night off. I have stripped down most of the outside along with him. I tried to dig a big hole to level the ship, and all it did was want to roll more. After I dug a big hole, instead of it going down in the hole, it rose out of the hole. Don't ask me why, but it did. So, that's essentially what it is. I have put two stanchions to keep the vessel from rolling completely over and crushing the cargo containers. And the arc generator. He's gonna need to do something fairly quickly. Think of if he builds a wall on the side where the two cargo containers are. So when the vessel does roll over from the eventual weight, it will not crush the cargo containers and everything will come to a rest on that side. But it's so heavy that it's heavier than the refineries that are refining the material. I checked my center of gravity, and my center of gravity is my cargo, and it's right dead center of the ship. So it's not off to the left or the right or anything else. I made sure my center of gravity was correct. You can check your center of gravity by going into your settings, and you can tell it to set to show your center of gravity in the game. By pressing K at a keypad, and it will show you the center of gravity. Just like the center of gravity is right where those two batteries are. Well, where one originally was, but they've been moved to the left now from where I am. So this vessel will never go to the surface because it's a static vessel. It is in space. Static vessel. Unless I turn it into a ship. I was kind of disappointed when I got down to the Earth-like planet. I did not see my satellite. Or my Earth. Space station. I thought I would see some sort of a reflection, but I could see the GPS mark overhead, but I could not see the reflection, even with the sun on the solar panels. That's how that goes, unfortunately. And about it. I wish I could have seen it, but just not possible. Thank you. I am going to make myself a arc reactor for my own vessel. I have been collecting the components. It takes a very, very long time. And it takes a very long time to assemble them. Cargo container was empty and just had all my arc reactor components. No longer does. I was hoping to move those arc components over to my collection. Looks like I'm going to have to build another cargo container. Find space for it because I've been refining like a mad maniac. Just to get this done. Anyway, I'm moving this stuff over. Because I don't have any room. I don't know why that went to the connector and not to what was supposed to, but it went to cargo connector. These are what's are going to do the rest of the solar panels. There's not very much I can do right now. I'm just waiting for materials to be processed. But once that happens, I gotta get, whatchamacallit, to get off the planet to move his ship. Because now my space station has come to a halt. As his ship is now parked on top of my space station. Both of them are drawing power from my space station, along with my own ship. So that's where we are. So I will talk to you guys tomorrow. I should say in the morning. It's early in the morning, but talk to you guys in a few hours and there. And you'll see, oh, I managed to make the space station partially airtight. The area I am standing in, I am not wearing a helmet, as you can see. It is airtight, and I am standing by a cargo container, so I don't have a problem. Eventually, I am going to add a gravity generator, and my space station can't be seen from any of those places. I'm not going to increase the size. Obviously, flying it out of the question can. Now, converting it to a spaceship, it would blow up. That's all I could say. Have a nice night. And take care.